Good afternoon, everyone. Thanks for your company. You're listening to Gerry Kelly, and I'm with you through until 2 o'clock this afternoon. We have some great guests for you this afternoon, including the one and only Alfie Boe, the internationally renowned tenor. Alfie is in Belfast because of the proms in the park tonight up at the Titanic Slipways. He arrived simply yesterday afternoon, and he rushed in for an interview with me yesterday. He was very busy today, obviously couldn't come in because of rehearsals, but he did come in yesterday and had a very entertaining chat with Alfie Boe, and we'll be hearing that in about 10 minutes time or so. Coming up very shortly, the one and only Alfie Boe, after we hear from Neil Sedaka. Neil Sedaka and Breaking Up Is Hard To Do. Talking about breaking things up, the boxing ring, well, it's been broken up. Maybe not broken up, but it's certainly been taken down after last weekend's big Frampton fight at the Titanic Slipways. But it's now been replaced by an even bigger stage to accommodate this year's proms in the park. It's all happening tonight. I'll tell you more about that later. But if you're lucky enough to be one of the 11,000 people to have a free ticket for the event, I'll tell you what, you're in for a major treat. Headlining the proms this year is the internationally renowned tenor Alfie Boe. And I'm absolutely delighted to say that almost immediately after he touched down in Belfast yesterday, he called in here for a chat. Alfie, it's good to see you back in Northern Ireland. This is a sort of happy hunting ground for you, is it not?
It's hunting ground, that's great, man. No, it's always good to be back here. I love it. I've been coming to Belfast performing for over the last 20 years now.
Really?
Yeah. First came here with the Doily Cart, with a production of HMS Pinafore and De Fledermaus. And that was a great time. Great time. I don't remember much of the performances, but I do remember sitting in a bar watching horse racing and getting absolutely blind drunk, drinking a lot of Bushmills.
Was that before you were Alfie Boe?
That was when I was Daniel O'Donnell. It's always good to play here. The audiences are always up for a good time, good laugh. I love playing Belfast, and especially getting the opportunity to play where we are on the slipway to at the Titanic Museum. It's going to be wonderful. I can't wait to see
you haven't actually seen the location yet.
No.
You will be stunned by it when you see it. Cool. Have you got your repertoire sorted out?
I have, yes. It's all of Daniel's material. I'm doing 3 songs from my latest album, Serenata, which is out in November. It's a great album. It's really reasonably priced as well. It's a good
Our
album.
Time's that tough, really.
Yeah. I've got to plug it, man. You've given me the opportunity. I've got a red microphone in front of me. You know, beautiful Neapolitan songs. I'm doing 3 of them tonight. One is Volare, the second is Buona Sera, and the third one is the theme tune to the movie Il Postino. So it's a contemporary piece. It's not really officially a Neapolitan aria, but I put my own words to it. And it's clean.
In Italian?
Yeah, no, in English.
Oh, in English.
Yeah, and it is clean. And it's clean. Yeah, it's clean. I put my own words to the theme tune of Il Postino. Yeah.
Fantastic.
It took me about 5 years, but it was.
You got there.
So I got there in the end.
What's it like, Alfie? You know, you have the Ulster Orchestra behind you, which they are magnificent. Have you played with the Ulster Orchestra before?
I have, yes.
And you know
many
how
times.
Good they are.
They're beautiful.
You will have 11,000 people
in the orchestra. In the orchestra. That's a big orchestra, man. Wow.
A crowd of 11,000 people.
Yeah.
What's that feeling like, standing up, entertaining a crowd like that?
It's great. It's wonderful. I mean, the power that these guys put out behind you, you know, the energy that they have when they're playing, each individual player unites each other with their own abilities, their own talents, and it's wonderful to have that body of sound come through and you blend yourself with that sound, and then to see the reaction, it's like a wave. Just you can see it working throughout the crowd. It's wonderful. I love it.
And you get that night after night when you perform. It's a wonderful life, isn't it?
It never happened in the cabaret bars in Blackpool, unfortunately. But, you know, and you got a squeaky little Hammond organ.
Do you remember those days?
I do.
Well, it's good because then you appreciate the days that you have today.
Exactly, yeah.
All the better. Yeah. Have you done proms before elsewhere?
I've been involved in the proms again probably for the last 15 years. I've played the Belfast prom before. We did Carrickfergus a long time ago.
That's right, I've forgotten that.
Thanks. It was obviously my...
Well, you weren't Alfie Boe then, were you?
I was, So that performance was really memorable. Yeah, cheers, Gerry. Anyway, take care, man. All the best.
Cheers, Alfie, cheers. Bye. Good luck tomorrow night up at the Titanic Centre.
I'll tell you what,
that concert at Carrickfergus, the last proms, was brilliant. I remember it well.
Really, yeah.
You were in it.
You're backpedalling now. That was good. That was good.
That was good. And good you fun. Enjoyed that?
Yes, I did.
So is that the only other proms you've done?
No, I've done the proms in the park in London, Glasgow, Swansea and Cardiff. So, I've been around.
You've done them all.
Yeah.
Are you involved in any shows at the moment? Or will you be going back into any shows in this foreseeable future?
The only show that's coming up at the moment, which I'm really excited about, and I'm working on quite a lot, doing a lot of production calls on it, is my arena tour. And that will be starting end of November for 2 weeks. Unfortunately, we're not coming to Belfast this time. Unfortunately, I know I'm pretty disappointed about that, because the last time I was here, it was the last night of the tour, and it was a riot. The audience was just fantastic. And yeah, I'm a little disappointed we're not coming here, but we are playing Liverpool, we're playing Manchester, so if you guys can make it over, I'll buy you all beers.
Will you?
I'll buy everybody a beer from
Northern
from
Ireland.
Belfast, yeah. Everybody.
This could cost you.
That's my fee gun. twice. So you're going to come to that one?
Yes, if I get a free drink.
You'll probably forget that one again after a couple of days.
No, because I love the one in Carrickfergus. That's
really?
Oh, really?
Carrickfergus went down so well.
That was such a big
It was
night.
Lovely seeing you there. Mm,
thanks.
You. Yeah,
thanks for the drink afterwards.
Yeah. God bless you.
I want to come on to something else. The new album.
Yes.
Which is called
Serenata. Yeah.
And if you sort of pre-ordered it,
yeah,
there was a little bonus for those people who pre-ordered it.
Another beer?
No.
No, okay.
They would have got a calendar of Alfie Boe. Alfie, really?
Yeah.
A calendar?
You know, I mean, you've got to make a living, haven't you?
Alfie. I haven't seen any of these pictures yet. Right. By any chance would you be topless in any of them?
I've been working out for it. Obviously, you can tell. I've been working hard. Yeah. No. No topless shots, no muscle shots. It's me.
What a 12-month character of 12 glorious shots of Alfie Boe.
It's when you get to Christmas, it's just a picture of me, you know, me dressed as Santa Claus. Or Rudolph, actually, sorry. I won't tell you where the red nose goes.
Are times that tough?
Well, you know, other people do it. I thought, I haven't got a clue why I've done it, to be honest. I don't know. But it'll be nice, I'm sure, for some people.
You don't
people.
Have one with you, by any more chance. We could go to it as a prize.
Unfortunately, you do have three coming to your home.
Alfie, it's a joy talking to you.
Jerry,
thanks so much for coming in. Enjoy the proms.
Thank you, thank
and,
you.
And good luck with the new album when it comes out.
The proms will be just as good as Carrickfergus, I think. You know.
Which was a memorable
That
event.
Was just outstanding.
Cheers, Alfie.
To dream the impossible dream, to fight the unbeatable foe, to bear with unbearable sorrow, to run where the brave dare not go,
to right the unrightable wrong, to love pure and chaste from afar, to try when your arms are too weary, to reach the unreachable star.
This is my quest, to follow that star, no matter how hopeless, no matter how far,
to fight for the right without question or pause,
to be willing to march into hell for a heavenly cause. And I know if I'll only be true to this glorious quest, that my heart will lie peaceful and calm when I'm laid to my rest.
And the world will be better for this, that one man, scorned and covered with scars,
still strove with his last ounce of courage to reach the unreachable stars. And I know if I'll only be true to this glorious quest, that my heart will lie peaceful and calm when I'm laid to my rest.
And the world will be better for this, that one man, scorned and covered with scars,
still strove with his last ounce of courage to reach the unreachable.
What a voice, that's Alfie Boe. And incidentally, singing along with Alfie Boe on that particular track, The Impossible Dream, was Matt Lucas. You know Matt Lucas from Little Britain? He and Alfie struck up a great friendship a couple of years ago. And indeed, Alfie actually invited Matt to appear in Les Mis, would you believe? Matt played the part of Thénardier. And they have a great friendship, so that's the two of them there. And he's a great sense of humour, has Alfie Boe. And I know you're going to enjoy the Proms tonight.